Surah 14 of the Holy Quran, translated by Muhammad Habib Shakir. This LibriVox recording is in the public domain. Surah 14, Ibrahim, revealed at Mecca. In the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent, the Most Merciful. Alif Lam Ra. This is a book which we have revealed to you that you may bring forth men by the Lord's permission from utter darkness into light to the way of the Mighty, the Praised One. Of Allah, whose is whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth, and woe to the unbelievers on account of the severe chastisement. To those who love this world's life more than the hereafter, and turn away from Allah's path, and desire to make it crooked, these are in a great error. And we did not send any messenger but with the language of his people, so that he might explain to them clearly. Then Allah makes whom he pleases err, and he guides whom he pleases, and he is the Mighty, the Wise. And certainly we sent Musa with our communications, saying, Bring forth your people from utter darkness into light, and remind them of the days of Allah. Most surely there are signs in this for every patient, grateful one. And when Musa said to his people, Call to mind Allah's favor to you, when he delivered you from Pharaoh's people, who subjected you to severe torment, and slew your sons, and spared your women. And in this there was a great trial from your Lord. And when your Lord made it known, If you are grateful, I would certainly give to you more. And if you are ungrateful, my chastisement is truly severe. And Musa said, If you are ungrateful, you and those on earth all together, most surely Allah is self-sufficient, praised. Has not the account reached you of those before you, of the people of Nuh and Ad and Samud, and those after them? None knows them but Allah. Their messengers come to them with clear arguments, but they thrust their hands into their mouth and said, Surely we deny that with which you are sent, and most surely we are in serious doubt as to that to which you invite us. Their messengers said, Is there doubt about Allah, the maker of the heavens and the earth? He invites you to forgive you your faults and to respite you till an appointed term. They said, You are nothing but mortals like us. You wish to turn us away from what our fathers used to worship? Bring us therefore some clear authority. Their messengers said to them, We are nothing but mortals like yourselves, but Allah bestows his favors on whom he pleases of his servants, and it is not for us that we should bring you an authority except by Allah's permission, and on Allah should the believers rely. And what reason have we that we should not rely on Allah? And he has indeed guided us in our ways. And certainly we would bear with patience your persecution of us, and on Allah should the reliant rely. And those who disbelieved said to their messengers, We will most certainly drive you forth from our land, or else you shall come back into our religion. So their Lord revealed to them, Most certainly we will destroy the unjust, and most certainly we will settle you in the land after them. This is for him who fears standing in my presence and who fears my threat. And they ask for judgment, and every insolent opposer was disappointed. Hell is before him, and he shall be given to drink of festering water. He will drink it little by little, and will not be able to swallow it agreeably, and death will come to him from every quarter, but he shall not die, and there shall be vehement chastisement before him. The parable of those who disbelieve in their Lord. Their actions are like ashes on which the wind blows, hard on a stormy day. They shall not have power over anything out of what they have earned. This is the great error. Do you not see that Allah created the heavens and the earth with truth? If He please, He will take you off and bring a new creation. And this is not difficult for Allah. And they shall all come forth before Allah. Then the weak shall say to those who were proud, "Surely we were your followers. Can you therefore avert from us any part of the chastisement of Allah?" They would say, "If Allah had guided us, we too would have guided you." It is the same to us whether we are impatient now or patient. There is no place for us to fly to. And the shaitan shall say after the affair is decided, "Surely Allah promised you the promise of truth, and I gave you promises, then failed to keep them to you, and I had no authority over you, except that I called you, and you obeyed me. Therefore, do not blame me, but blame yourselves. I cannot be your aider now, nor can you be my aiders. Surely I disbelieved in your associating me with Allah before. Surely it is the unjust that shall have the painful punishment. And those who believe and do good are made to enter gardens beneath which rivers flow, to abide in them by their Lord's permission. Their greeting therein is peace. Have you not considered how Allah sets forth a parable of a good word being like a good tree, whose root is firm and whose branches are in heaven, yielding its fruit in every season by the permission of its Lord? And Allah sets forth parables for men that they may be mindful. And the parable of an evil word is as an evil tree pulled up from the earth's surface. It has no stability. Allah confirms those who believe with the sure word in this world's life and in the hereafter. And Allah causes the unjust to go astray. And Allah does what He pleases. Have you not seen those who have changed Allah's favor for ungratefulness and made their people to alight into the abode of perdition, into hell? They shall enter into it, and an evil place it is to settle in. And they set up equals with Allah, that they may lead people astray from His path. Say, "Enjoy yourselves, for surely your return is to the fire." Say to my servants who believe that they should keep up prayer and spend out of what we have given them secretly and openly before the coming of the day in which there shall be no bartering nor mutual befriending. Allah is He who created the heavens and the earth and sent down water from the clouds, then brought forth with it fruits as a sustenance for you. And He has made the ships subservient to you, that they might run their course in the sea by His command. And He has made the rivers subservient to you. And He has made subservient to you the sun and the moon pursuing their courses. And He has made subservient to you the night and the day. And He gives you of all that you ask Him. And if you count Allah's favors, you will not be able to number them. Most surely, man is very unjust, very ungrateful. And when Ibrahim said, "My Lord, make this city secure, and save me and my sons from worshipping idols. My Lord, surely they have led many men astray. then whoever follows me, he is surely of me, and whoever disobeys me, thou surely art forgiving, merciful. O our Lord, surely I have settled a part of my offspring in a valley unproductive of fruit near thy sacred house. Our Lord, that they may keep up prayer, therefore make the hearts of some people yearn towards them and provide them with fruits. Haply they may be grateful. O our Lord, surely thou knowest what we hide and what we make public, and nothing in the earth nor anything in heaven is hidden from Allah. Praise be to Allah, who has given me in old age Ismail and Ishaq. Most surely my Lord is the hearer of prayer. My Lord, make me keep up prayer, and from my offspring too. O our Lord, and accept my prayer. O our Lord, grant me protection and my parents and the believers on the day when the reckoning shall come to pass. And do not think Allah to be heedless of what the unjust do. He only respites them to a day on which the eyes shall be fixedly open, hastening forward, their heads upraised, their eyes not reverting to them, and their hearts vacant. And warn people of the day when the chastisement shall come to them. Then those who were unjust will say, O our Lord, respite us to a near term, so we shall respond to thy call and follow the messengers. What? Did you not swear before that there will be no passing away for you? And you dwell in the abodes of those who were unjust to themselves, and it is clear to you how we dealt with them, and we have made them examples to you. And they have indeed planned their plan, but their plan is with Allah. Though their plan was such that the mountains should pass away thereby. Therefore do not think Allah to be one failing in his promise to his messengers. Surely Allah is mighty, the Lord of retribution. On the day when the earth shall be changed into a different earth, and the heavens as well, and they shall come forth before Allah, the One, the Supreme. And you will see the guilty on that day linked together in chains, their shirts made of pitch, and the fire covering their faces, that Allah may requite each soul according to what it has earned. Surely Allah is swift in reckoning. This is a sufficient exposition for the people, and that they may be warned thereby, and that they may know that He is one Allah, and that those possessed of understanding may mind. End of Surah 14.